Welcome back to The Deep State, presented by Eclipse, Inc. On today's episode, we have Larry Pang, head of ecosystem at IoTeX. This episode is sponsored by Eclipse Labs. Eclipse is building Ethereum's fastest layer 2, powered by the Solana virtual machine. Eclipse combines Solana's performance and scalability with Ethereum's security. To get the best of both worlds, you can read more about Eclipse mainnet at www.eclipse.builders. We'll have a little bit more on them later in the show. Before we get started, make sure you hit the like, subscribe, smash the bell, all the rad stuff. Make sure that we can help keep bringing great guests like Larry to you. Larry, thanks for coming on, man.
Excited to be here. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, I mean, I'm pumped. We're so it's December 19th. We'll probably release this in the next couple of days, but we are right in the middle of some DePIN craziness, and IoTeX is really at the center of it. Walk me through what you see going on right now with IoTeX and DePIN.
Yeah, you know, it's an exciting time for DePIN and crypto as a whole. You know, I think after a long, drawn-out bear cycle, you were starting to see some life being breathed back into crypto, and also seeing DePIN emerge as a big trend for 2024. And a lot of this is just due to heads down building from all the builders in DePIN for the past couple of years. And now the fruits of their labor are starting to sprout, and no different from IoTeX. So excited to share everything that's going on with IoTeX and WebStream and all of our new products that we've been building over the past couple of years. But just to take a, you know, bird's eye view of the DePIN sector right now, it's great. You know, like, we started IoTeX 5 years ago. And at the time, you know, any intersections of blockchain with the Internet of Things or with finance were a little hard to understand. And, you know, the connection of the real world to the digital world made the whole thing a little confusing to people. But now that there are projects like Helium and HiveMapper and Demo and a lot of these sensor networks emerging that are not just conceptual anymore, but the hardware footprint is out there. People are earning tokens for creating utility, contributing data. It's starting to become a lot more real. And when DePIN projects seem real, it's not just like magic internet money like DeFi. You have mainstream people know that, hey, I can install this physical device and earn tokens for contributing. And I think that's, you know, crossing a chasm for a lot of these mainstream folks that is going to really bring a lot of attention to DePIN from the masses, right?
But just an exciting
time. You know, I think we're all happy to see the industry propel and just getting excited for a big 2024.
Yeah, no, it's going to be cool. And you guys have been really good about making sure that IoTeX is really a space for players in the DePIN game to kind of come and do their thing and not have to worry about some of the back end stuff. Walk me through this kind of latest incarnation with this modular tech stack idea and how you guys are providing this infrastructure and separating it out.
Absolutely. You know, so IoTeX, we got started 5 years ago, and from like day one, we wanted to build infrastructure and tooling that allowed DePIN builders to launch their networks faster and more securely, right? So it's our job as an infrastructure and a platform provider to kind of predict like what the applications of the future and applications of today need in order to make their lives easier, right? It's this exact same concept as, you know, what AWS and GCP do on the cloud side, except we're thinking about, okay, what do DePIN projects actually need? And we've learned a lot in the past couple of years about what they need. You know, we started off building a layer one blockchain that's really scalable and secure and decentralized. That's a prerequisite to everything here, right? The base layer. But on top of that, we've really been focused this past year on creating hardware-oriented middleware tools and an off-chain computing environment that makes data from DePIN devices easier to process and easier to marry with the Web3 world, right? So two of our big products that we're in the process of launching and you know, maturing is one is called Device Connect. And that's really a suite of SDKs that allow people to give on-chain identities to devices, grab data from those devices, and bind device identities with user identities, right? So that's a really important technical component of what DePIN projects need is device identity and device webhooks in a way, right?
Yep.
Another massive product that, you know, maybe a lot of people have heard about our progress is WebStream. And WebStream is this off-chain computing environment where we grab the data from those devices and create Web3 compatible proofs of real-world activity that are then sent to the layer one. So this is kind of the modular tech stack concept, right? You have this module that focuses on devices. You have this module that's focused on the data and computing over that data. You have the base layer, which is where all this activity is settled. You have our cross-chain bridge. You have our DPIN oriented user-facing wallet. So these are all different modules that are synchronized really perfectly together. But you know, we see a lot of projects using the entire tech stack, and we see some people picking a la carte which one of those that they want. Maybe they just want to use the bridge. Maybe they just want to use WebStream. Maybe they rarely do they just want to use the layer one. But it's really given the optionality to DPIN builders, and we're starting to see more and more folks really explore what building on the full tech stack looks like. So yeah, all of these things have their own roadmaps also. So it's like it's not easy to just summarize how everything's going, but the long-term goal is get this entire tech stack to work seamlessly together. And we're definitely on our way there.
Yeah, and you guys are also looking forward into the privacy space. I think we were talking a little bit that this whole ZK thing is coming for you. You're already planning for it. It's already on the roadmap for you. Do you want to walk me through a little bit of that?
Yeah. You know, ZK has really taken the industry by storm, especially like in the first half of this year, I would say. This whole concept of zero knowledge proofs, right? It's interesting to see that a lot of people were using zero knowledge for like layer two scalability. It's definitely one of the benefits of ZK technologies is that you can kind of net transactions in a way that makes blockchains a lot more scalable. But the thing that hasn't been really applied is kind of the privacy preserving aspect of this zero knowledge proof, right? It just so happens to have great scalability benefits as well. But the primary use case of ZK, I think, is privacy preservation, right? And when you think about use cases or industries where privacy preserving technologies are really needed, DPIN stands out as like a top candidate, right? Because you're talking about what people are doing in the real world. If they're wearing their Apple Watch, or they're driving somewhere, or they're setting up their DPIN devices on their homes, there's a lot of personally identifiable information and geolocation type of details that you want to abstract away, but you still want to be able to use that data and use those devices and participate in these Web3 ecosystems, right? So ZK in combination with DPIN has always been a really core focus of IoTeX. And we're working on a lot of pretty cool demos with some of the larger DPIN projects in the space right now to demonstrate zero knowledge proofs of real world activity. And, you know, this is really exciting because in the past year, we've done a lot of business development. And admittedly, when we bring WebStream and some of our modules to the incumbents in the DPIN sector, they're saying, man, we already spent 6 months building our own custom tech stack. You know, we don't want to re-migrate over. And, you know, if we were starting from scratch today, we absolutely would use WebStream and some of the modules, but we're so deep already. We can't just scrap everything we've done, right? But that's for some of the more basic kind of things within the DPIN sector, right? How do you grab data? How do you issue tokens to the right types of users? How do you verify that all the things are done correctly? But the one thing I think that's really going to bring IoTeX's tech stack into the larger DPIN players is this ZK stuff, because really nobody knows how to do this within their own teams, right? This is the really core focus of IoTeX, and we have a lot of expertise in the cryptography side, like the zero knowledge cryptography side. And if we bring this capability to DPIN builders, this is really something that they don't want to build themselves and honestly don't have the chops to build it themselves, right? So we're bringing some brand new innovation. We're not just saving time for something that they could have done themselves, maybe just in a little longer time frame, right? So that's something that we're really excited for, is really bringing DPIN to the next level and working with a lot of these larger projects on the ZK side.
Yeah, that's super cool to see you guys thinking ahead and making sure you're supporting, or maybe folks aren't even thinking about where they're going to go. They're just so head down building what they've got, and you guys will be ready when they are. Let's take a quick break. We'll talk about today's sponsor, Eclipse Labs. One of the cool parts about doing this show is we get to talk tons of projects across the space, including back-end nerdy stuff that helps deepen projects. One of those is today's show sponsor, Eclipse Labs, who's building Ethereum's fastest layer 2 to support several deepen projects. Eclipse leverages the best parts of the modular stack, Solana for execution, Celestia for scalability, and Ethereum for security. Eclipse is committed to helping projects build on DPIN. Check them out at eclipse.builders and check out the interview we did with Neil at Eclipse if you haven't seen it. Now, you guys at IoTeX are doing really similar things, and it's been super cool to see you kind of reach across to other projects like Solana and say, hey, let's figure out how we work together. So kind of kudos to you guys for doing this cross-project work. And I guess a piece of that maybe we should talk about is this DPINscan.io thing. So just making it really easy for folks to find out what's going on. Walk me through what's going on there.
Yeah, so when we think about what DPIN projects need, again, right, we just talked a lot about what they need from a technology standpoint, but they also need things that are not purely technology focused. And, you know, things about like getting your, bootstrapping your ecosystem, bootstrapping your community, getting the visibility of your first 100 devices, your first steps of traction, and getting your token into the hands of people that are not just scavengers, but real people that want to be a long-term contributor to your project.
Yep.
A lot of these like go-to-market support strategies is also something that we've heard directly from projects saying, hey, look, you know, when the time comes, we're going to use your ZK tech stack and we're going to use WebStream. But right now, we just need to focus on building out our first 100 core users. And we want people to know about us so we can attract the next 100, right? So baby steps. DPIN Scan is really a way for us to aggregate all of the information from projects, big and small. So people get a full lay of the land of the larger projects that have hundreds of thousands of devices out there in five or so continents. And also the ones that are just starting, maybe with a more regional focus. They have like 100 devices in Oklahoma. But that's meaningful traction that people should know about, right? So as we think about, okay, how do we cater to projects that are brand new and also projects that are, you know, the OGs of the sector. Visibility is something that all projects really desire. So really encourage everyone to check out dpinscan.io. It's a place where you can see the profile pages of the core of DPIN today, not only where those devices are sitting, but the profiles of them. And that also kind of connects to another initiative of ours called the DPIN Liquidity Hub, which not only gives you the information about these projects, but also allows people to buy and trade all of the DPIN tokens across multiple blockchains in one place. And that's done on DEX on IoTeX called MIMO. So, you know, I think this go-to-market support is really our way of bringing all of the DPIN activity from different chains together and giving them a home at IoTeX, right? I think given the focus on the modularity of our tech stack, we also want the modularity to spread to other blockchains, right? A lot of people ask us, like, why are you so friendly with Polygon? Why are you so friendly with Solana? Well, it's because, yes, we have a layer one, but we have an entire suite of tools that are designed to be modular and can work with any other layer one. So if there are DPIN apps on Solana, DPIN apps on Polygon, DPIN apps on IoTeX, eventually the long-term vision for us is we're going to bring all that activity under one hood as the DPIN stack. But yeah, these are just some things that are not on the technical side that, you know, are really exciting too. So encourage people to check out those initiatives.
Yeah. Now you guys are crushing. And it was super good to see as well. You did some work with the Future Money Group. I just saw this announcement, $5 million for a DPIN accelerator. That's super exciting to see. I know Max and I are talking about working with you guys on that and making sure we kind of put our shoulder to the wheel there too, to help some of these projects. So really cool to see all of the work that IoTeX is doing in this space.
So, absolutely. Yeah.
Super psyched. Dude, thanks so much for making the time today. I really appreciate you coming on.
For sure. Yeah. Look out for some cool announcements in January. I think on our developer relations Twitter, we've been teasing the next WebStream release. It's called Sprout, and it's going to move WebStream from being a kind of a test network to a decentralized network that is supporting real projects. So, last plug for today, but really appreciate it. Happy holidays, everyone. And let's have a big 2024.
Yeah. Yeah. No, plug it up. We'll put a link down to the accelerator. So projects watching this know how to join up, but yeah, super psyched to help you guys wherever we can. And thanks again for making the time today.
Sounds good. See you guys.